aalisin ko ang income tax ng mga kababayan natin na kumikita buwan-buwan ng 30,000 piso at pababa.
It was indeed music to the ears of hardworking Filipinos who earn little but are heavily taxed. But since this is the election season, it would also help if voters would be wary of campaign promises, especially if they would have a huge impact on the public coffers. Former Finance Secretary Gary Teves is one of Vice President Jejomar Binay's campaign advisors on the economy. He believes Binay could deliver on the promise to remove income tax for those earning 30,000 pesos or less. But unlike his presidential candidate, Teves sounded more prudent.
When he made that announcement, I was not privy to the assumptions made. So I think it will probably have to go through some analysis. But like most objectives, what we try to do is try to attain it and see how best we can attain it in the most feasible manner.
Teves says Binay's campaign promise can be achieved, especially given Binay's supposed track record of fiscal prudence when he was mayor of Makati. Still, Teves says a Binay presidency would have to deal with what revenues would be available.
We would have to look at the numbers and say, if this is really the most important, there may have to be some objectives or programs that will have to be deferred or delayed. As a consultant or advisor, our role is to try to do some rough computation on how much this will all cost. And later on, if he makes it, we will have to inform him that these are the implications of this particular objective. And overall, this is how the numbers will look like.
But Binay still has other promises. He vowed to expand the conditional cash transfer program, which already has a budget of more than 62 billion pesos this year. He also promised free books, school supplies, and uniforms for public school students, just like in Makati.
In the end, I think we have to determine which of these statements that were made during the campaign period are the most crucial for the electorate or the population.
Christian Esguerra, ABS-CBN News.